Hi people, as I'm engraving, concentrate on the front of the graver. Just observe what's happening. And I'm going to explain something that might help you with hill drag. I've kind of analysed it. And I think I've, because I haven't engraved for so long, I'm kind of relearning. Soon comes back to you, but you have a little opportunity to kind of work out what you're doing. I think in any profession, after a while, you don't know how to do it. You just do it. You've done all your mistakes. Right. So what I'm going to explain is I'm going to carry on with this curve, and then I'll explain because. When you can, you got to do it. Ah, fuck. Right, so what I'm going to explain about is the way the graver cuts through the metal. Is like the bottom of a boat sailing through the water. So the shape of a the cutting profile of our graver is this, say roughly this angle, but all gravers are a V. So that's the groove they cut is a V. So what you want to kind of aim for is, right, I'll do it. It's not, there's no wrong and there's no right to this, but just be aware of it, right? When you're cutting a line, you really want to keep the graver like that. But then as you go around the corner, the tendency will be to lean it over. So what you got to do is, as you're turning, you've got to constantly be lifting this back up. You see what I mean? So if you want a really nice, crisp, neat line, then you this is the adjustment you got to do. And then all you got to do is, I mean, because I use a microscope, it really gives you an advantage, but you know, you want to be using an optimizer. But if you had quite a large faced graver, then you would see it better, but I think you'd probably be able to manage. But just keep this in mind. So you're turning a corner, right? So yeah, so it's driving around a corner, the tendency is to lean over one way or the other, actually, because you've kind of got, if you're right-handed, overarm anti-clockwise seems more comfortable than counterclockwise, and I presume it's the same for left-handed. But anyway, keep that in mind. You know, you can lean the graver for effect, but if you want a nice neat line, if you think you're a bit raggedy, then that's what you're missing. You, as you go around the corner, you're leaning right over, and that's where you can kind of get heel drag. If you maintain that all the time, it should be all good. But you can actually manipulate that effect and see, it creates a wavy line. I don't know if you can appreciate it, but I love it. It's like an ink pen. So what do you want to do? Do you want to draw with a biro or do you want to draw with a quill? So up to you. You can do beautiful art with both. But I maintain that the line is beautiful, not so much or you try to get it as beautiful as you can. Right, hope that helps everybody. Cheers, bye.